السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, teach us what benefit us from what He taught us, and increase us in knowledge. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, put barakah in this gathering and make us from the people who will be told, get up, all your sins are forgiven. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Brother Shah, I like to see you in front of me here. You're my assistant. Brother Mustafa, where's Brother Mustafa? He's outside, I think. Brother Mustafa is probably the last Hajji to come back from Hajj. He just came back yesterday. I want to welcome him. He went to his country and just got back. Ahlan wa sahlan bishaykh. Tfaddal. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. So we continue inshaAllah ta'ala with the names of Allah Azza wa Jal. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people who listen and apply. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make these gatherings hujja ma'ana wa laysa alayna. To make these gatherings as a witness with us, not against us. Today's name is Al-Hamid. Al-Hamid. Obviously, the root of this name is very easy, which is Ha, Mim, Dal, right? Hamd. Ha, Mim, Dal. Al-Hamid means the most praiseworthy, the most praiseworthy, the praised one. And it appeared in the Quran 16 times. Most of the time is associated with Al-Ghani. Excellent, mashallah. Al-Ghani, subhanallah. The Ghani, he is the one who is deserves all the praise. Subhanallah, what a beautiful combination. Al-Ghani, Al-Hamid. The one who does not need anybody. And at the same time, he deserves all the gratitude and shukr. He is the one who deserves all praise and honor. Al-Hamid is the only one who is truly worthy of all praise and thanks. Al-Hamid comes from Hamim Dal. Linguistically, Hamd is based on Mahabba and Ta'zim, both together. Mahabba and Ta'zim. And it implies admiration and gratitude towards the one who is praised, Al-Mahmud. Mahmud, when you hear somebody's name is Mahmud, he's the one who is praised. Hamada, yani praised. Alhamdu, the praise. Mahmud is the person who's being praised. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is Al-Hamid. He is the one who's always deserving the praise. Some of the ayat, like I said, it's many, many ayat mentioned, the name. Some of them are, رحمة الله وبركاته عليكم أهل البيت إنه حميد مجيد ومن يشكر فإنما يشكر لنفسه ومن كفر فإن الله غني حميد وهو الذي ينزل الغيث من بعد ما قنطوا وينشر رحمته وهو الولي الحميد. And the beautiful ayah. يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله هو الغني الحميد. We are all فقراء to Allah عز وجل. We are the فقراء and He is the قوي. We are the ضعفاء. We are the فقراء and He is the غني. We are the ضعفاء and He is the قوي. Now what does it mean, Al-Hamid, in when it comes to Allah Azza wa Jal? It has few meanings. Number one, He is the one who is praised in all occasions. He is the one who's praised in all occasions. What does that mean? It means that if something good happened, I say Alhamdulillah, and if something evil happened, I say Alhamdulillah, always. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا رأى الإنسان What happened? All one blank. إذا رأى الإنسان خيرا فليحمد الله. If a person sees something good, let him say Alhamdulillah. And if he sees something bad, he says Alhamdulillah على كل حال. Alhamdulillah على كل حال. Subhanallah. Completely one blank. Okay. Bismillah. See, Bismillah, it came back. طيب. Alhamdulillah على كل حال. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is thanked in all occasions, in all situations. And the hadith that we all know, أمر المؤمن عجيب. The state and the affair of the believer is always عجيب. It's amazing. If something good happened to him, he is thankful and that is good for him. And if something evil happened to him, he is patient and that's also good for him. And that's only for the believer. Allahumma ja'alna minhum ya Rabb. He's always thankful. The believer is always thankful. Because I am doing my best to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. And whatever comes is from Allah. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. So, and you know, sometimes, ya Akhwan, we go through some all kinds of difficulties, accidents, sicknesses, all that. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Always keep in mind that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always wants the khair for you. And like we always repeat, you might not notice the khair right away, but definitely because of your trust and because you are a believer, you know that only khair is coming from Allah Azza wa Jal. You become thankful to Allah Azza wa Jal when you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses and decrees for you. This is a very important formula in our life. When we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses and decrees for me, whatever He decrees is better when I do for myself. It's better what I plan for myself. When I have that established, everything that happens, Allahumma laka alhamd. Because I don't know. أنا لست مدبر. هو المدبر. يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك أستغيث أصلح لي شأني كله ولا تكلني إلى نفسي طرفة عين. Do not leave me make my own decisions, not even for a blink of an eye. I cannot handle it. I don't know. I want this and I don't know if it's good for me or not. But you, Al-Alim, you, Al-Hakim. Second, it means that, Subhanallah, ya Akhwan, His hamd needs hamd. When something good happens to you, when you for example, Allah blessed you with a baby, you say Alhamdulillah. Allah blessed you with a job, Alhamdulillah, from the bottom of your heart. Or somebody asks you, how are you doing? Say Alhamdulillah. Allahumma laka alhamd. Alhamdulillah. That Alhamdulillah, who made you say Alhamdulillah? Allah. So that Alhamdulillah needs Alhamdulillah. So there's no end to it. There's no end. That's why Allah said, وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ One ni'mah, لَا تُحْصُوهَا. You cannot count one ni'mah. The benefits of one ni'mah, you cannot count it. So every Alhamdulillah needs Alhamdulillah, so it's non-stop. Subhanallah. So you might think, you know, because Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, we are from the people of the Masajid, and you know, but wallahi, don't take it for granted. Many people, I ask them, how are you doing? Fine, good, well. So when you say Alhamdulillah, don't think it just came up like that. Allah inspired you to say Alhamdulillah. Not everybody say Alhamdulillah. Not everybody says Alhamdulillah. And even if they say Alhamdulillah, and like, let's say for example, someone is going through so much hardship, okay? And you ask him, how are you doing? Alhamdulillah. What kind of Alhamdulillah is this? What kind of Alhamdulillah? It's all over your face. And Alhamdulillah, it's hardly coming out. No, Alhamdulillah is always, right? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. طيب. So, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, no servant is blessed by Allah and says Alhamdulillah except that what he was given is better than that which he has himself acquired. Third, He is the one that by saying Alhamdulillah gives you extreme reward. Just by saying Alhamdulillah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alhamdulillah. Remember I gave a khutbah one time about the scale. Wallahi, it's a very, very important topic. About the scale. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us it's an actual scale. It's an actual scale. And there are many different ahadith that told us what will be weighed. Some ahadith said you will be weighed. That's why it does not, you know, you will be actually weighed. Second, it says that the a'mal, the actions will be weighed. And third, hadith, the hadith of the sahifa. He said that the suhuf will be weighed. The ones that are written, the a'mal in them will be weighed. And so the ulama said all three will be weighed. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alhamdulillah, tamla' al-mizan. Tamla. It will fill up the mizan when you say Alhamdulillah. When you say Alhamdulillah. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminded us that after every salat, ya akhwan, Alhamdulillah. But unfortunately, like I mentioned one time, we say them so quickly because the dhikr of Allah azza wa jal is one of three stages. Either by the tongue alone, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Or by the heart, like you are working, you are doing something, but your heart is remembering Allah, saying Astaghfirullah inside. Or the best dhikr is when they are both combined together. You're saying Alhamdulillah and you remember a blessing. You're saying Subhanallah and you remember one of the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jal. They come combined. So when we say Alhamdulillah, ya akhwan, after the salat, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Sometimes I don't hear the people, but I see like this. Ya Allah. What did you just do? I said, Alhamdulillah, what Alhamdulillah? Like I said, that Astaghfirullah needs Astaghfirullah. So we have to, you are thanking Allah. You are thanking Allah. Remember the example I gave you? I say, Idris, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. What kind of thank you is this? You know, one beautiful thank you is better than all these thank yous that are so quick. Alhamdulillah, 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 Subhanallah. Tayyib. Listen to this. So we said that Allah rewards extreme rewards for simple a'mal. Listen to this, subhanAllah. And please, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, I've been saying this dua for now 4 or 5 years. And I would love everybody to come and learn it. Very simple, and we need it every single night. Because this dua, hardly anyone knows about it, and it's before we sleep. And I think, if I know you very well, we all sleep every night. So, قال عليه الصلاة والسلام من قال إذا أوى إلى فراشه الحمد لله الذي كفاني وآواني والحمد لله الذي أطعمني وسقاني الحمد لله الذي من علي فأفضل اللهم إني أسألك بعزتك أن تنجيني من النار. What happens if you say that? فقد حمد الله بجميع محامد الخلق كلهم. He has thanked Allah as much as all creation has thanked Allah. Wow. الحمد لله الذي كفاني. Let me explain it quickly because I know some people are going to come after. كفاني means from كفاية. كفاية same in Urdu. كفاية يكتفي. And he has. Yeah, sufficient. He sufficed me. Kafani wa awani. And he gave me a shelter, right? Because I'm going to sleep now, right? Alhamdulillah, ladhi at'amani wa saqani. Easy. At'amani wa saqani. Walhamdulillah, ladhi manna alayya faafdal. And he has favored me with so many favors, faafdal. And he overdid it. I don't deserve all that. Subhanallah. And then I ended by dua. اللهم إني أسألك بعزتك أن تنجيني من النار. Ya Allah, I ask you, this could be my last sleep, Ya Allah. I might not wake up. So I ask you, Ya Allah, with your izzah, to save me from the hellfire. فقد حمد. Look at this hadith. First of all, I thought it was weak, fabricated, something about it. So I checked 4 or 5 years ago, and alhamdulillah, 100% authentic. فقد حمد حمد الله بجميع محامد الخلق كلهم. الله أكبر. So, إن شاء الله تعالى, before you go, I can give it to you بإذن الله تعالى. And And you can say it every night. You could practice it, and then after a while, you will know it by heart. After I finish eating, is it subhanallah, how kareem is Allah Azza wa Jal? How he is really deserving all the hamd. Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amani hadha wa razaqnih min ghayri hawlin minni wala quwwa. All my sins are forgiven. After I finish eating, alhamdulillah alladhi at'amani hadha, al-akl yani, al-food, wa razaqnih. He gave me that rizq. I did not do anything. Min ghayri hawl. I have no might, no quwwa. I did not plant that lettuce. I did not raise that chicken. It came ready. Min ghayri hawlin minni wala quwwa. All your sins are forgiven. Subhanallah. Fourth, he is the one who is deserving all the hamd, even if no one thanked him. He is still deserving all the hamd, even if no one says alhamdulillah, he's still deserving all the hamd. وقال السعدي رحمه الله الحميد هو في ذاته وأسمائه وصفاته وأفعاله فله من الأسماء أحسنها ومن الصفات أكملها وأحسنها فإن أفعاله تعالى دائرة بين الفضل والعدل. سبحان الله. يعني very hard to translate, but it's so beautiful. He said that he is the Hamid in his names and in his attributes and in his actions, and he has the best of names and the best of attributes and the most perfect, and all his a'mal are between fadl and adl, between his favors and his just. And the last one is his hamd. Allah's hamd defies any time or any place. It's always. قال سبحانه وله الحمد في السماوات والأرض. This is place and time. وعشيا وحين تظهرون. At night and at dhuhr time. And he also said له الحمد في الأولى والآخرة. And he has the hamd here and in the آخرة. And subhanallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّكُمْ لَتُلْهَمُونَ التَّسْبِيحُ وَالتَّحْمِيدُ كَمَا تَلْهَمُونَ التَّنَفُّسُ. الله أكبر. He said, in Jannah, ya akhwan, in Jannah, وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Right? They still say alhamdulillah in Jannah. You still say alhamdulillah in Jannah. الَّذِي أَذْهَبَ عَنَّا الْحَزَنِ. He removed all kinds of grief. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith I narrated, he said that in Jannah, you will be تلهمون, يعني inspired to say subhanallah walhamdulillah, just like you are inspired in this dunya to breathe. Have you ever thought now, you said, okay guys, I'm going to breathe? No, we breathe instantly, right? Without thinking. Similarly, in Jannah, subhanallah walhamdulillah, come out just like we breathe. Allahu Akbar. So it is no time, no place, all the time, fi dunya wa fi al-akhirah, we are always saying alhamdulillah. We use this name, ya akhwan, by repeating constantly, alhamdulillah. Yani we mentioned many ahadith. For example, arba kalimat ahab ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mimma tala'at alayhi ash-shams. One of the most beloved words to Allah azza wa jal, subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illa Allah wallahu akbar. Many ahadith mentioning the reward of saying alhamdulillah. So one of the ways to constantly say alhamdulillah, and every time say it, remember one of the na'am of Allah azza wa jal. And finally, subhanallah. Let me ask you a question. Did Allah ever tell Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, say alhamdulillah? Which one? Naml? Okay. But there's another one, which is also the last ayah. I think it's the last ayah. What's the last ayah of Isra? وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا. Allahu Akbar. All of us, wallahi, we should say alhamdulillah that we do not believe that Allah has a son. Allahu Akbar. Look at this ni'mah. وَقُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ, say الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ وَلِيٌّ مِنَ الذُّلِّ وَكَبِّرْهُ تَكْبِيرًا. سبحان الله. Look at this ni'mah that we have every single day. وَقُلْ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا. Many people around us are every single day saying that Allah has a son. And we have the biggest ni'mah that Allah told His Prophet, His beloved, alayhi salatu wasalam, say, وَقُلْ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا. He never had a son, or a son should not ever be attributed to him. So this is if somebody asks you, what is the dalil that the best ni'mah is Islam, beside many dalil, many evidences, this is an evidence that the biggest ni'mah is that alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we do not believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a son. So ya akhwan, constantly thank Allah azza wa jal. Wallahi, if I ask you every single one of us right now, you know, name some of the ni'am that you have. Wallahi, we will stay till Fajr and we will not even start mentioning the ni'am. The ni'mah of hell, the ni'mah of Islam, the ni'mah of guidance which comes right after Islam, to be guided. The ni'mah of being in the masjid, the ni'mah of praying, the ni'mah of the health, the ni'mah of every single part of the body. All these blessings, wallahi, any time that you are going through difficulty, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send you a message about someone else who's going through worse than you. You know, brother Sifa, and some of you, there is a brother who used to be with us, and he moved back to Colorado. And his both sons, please keep them in your dua. Both of them are in the intensive care in a very, very, very sad situation. Very, yani, Allahu A'lam if they're going to make it or not. Two young, 14 and 16. Very, very young kids. Huh? 14 and how, Amro, what's the other one? Four? One is 14, one is 4? One is 15, one is 3. La ilaha illallah. The 15 years old is, they was trying to plant something. And what was it? Nukha? Khalaya al-Judaiya. Shul khalaya al-Judaiya, doctor? Bone marrow. And on the way to plant it, it got infected. And the doctor did not know, except after he already put it in the body. Now the kid is in intensive care. And the other one, the young one, has something with the blood cells that are not building up or something, subhanAllah. So he's taking shifts, subhanAllah. He's at night and the mother is in the morning, just sleeping in the ICU. So when you hear about these things, what kind of problem do you have? SubhanAllah, all your problems disappear, wallahi akhwan. As fathers, we know that anything that touches our children is like the worst thing could ever happen to us, subhanAllah. You know, so we please keep Brother Muhsin and his family in your dua, inshaAllah ta'ala. And remember that we are always in ni'am, la tu'ad wa la tuhsa. And he is still in a blessings that many other people will wish to have, subhanAllah. We are always grateful to you, ya Allah. Allahumma laka alhamd, Allahumma laka alhamdu hatta tarda. ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا. Ya Allah, we say alhamdulillah to you until you are pleased, and we say alhamdulillah to you after you are pleased. Subhanallah. We are always grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal, and to show gratitude, ya akhwan, always come to the masajid, come to the house of Allah Azza wa Jal, and thank Him here in His house. Fajr tomorrow at 6:45. This is the latest could ever be. Attend Fajr in Jama'ah tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala. Is the most beloved salat in the sight of Allah, is Fajr of Jumu'ah in Jama'ah. And make a lot of salat on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakumullah khair. Wabarakallah feekum. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, I will be giving the first khutbah.